During his interface with the traders on May 7th at Kololo Independence Grounds, President Yoweri Museveni issued a directive to Uganda Revenue Authority to halt and pardon penalties issued to traders who had defaulted on IFRS compliance. The president further directed extensive sensitization of the traders on the new development of tax remittance before rolling out the IFRS system. Today, URA has embarked on the process of pardoning the traders that had penalties of non-compliance. The Commissioner General of URA, John Musinguzi Rujoki, revealed the procedures to be followed by the applicant for penalty pardon.
Let us withdraw or waive the penalties we have issued. Fortunately, the law allows us to do that. As you know, the process of waiving any tax is clearly spelled out in the law. It is no man's discretion. Commissioner General or any commissioner here cannot stand and say, I'm waiving tax. No. The law spells out under what circumstances tax can be waived.
Musinguzi advised traders who have the said penalty to report to URA officers by Friday to work out the waiver. The traders who have been pardoned were issued with certificates and cautioned against non-compliance. Derek Basali Rachigenyi, the deputy coordinator of the National Coordination Office for Prevention of Trafficking in Persons at the Ministry of Internal Affairs, has said that last Wednesday, in collaboration with International Organization for Migration, successfully repatriated 23 Ugandans who had been trafficked to Myanmar.
Last week, on Wednesday, government, through the Ministry of Foreign Affairs and other partners like International Organization for Migration, successfully repatriated our Ugandans, 23 of them, 18 male and 5 female.
Ugandans were cautioned to watch out for human traffickers who target the desperate, unsuspecting people, promising them a better livelihood abroad.
To this effect, we also come back, as we have always done, to address the public to the same matter. We have always come out to encourage you to talk to you about the same and to also discourage those that would think of heading out some of these countries, that the danger still stands, the risk is still there in Myanmar. Don't you get duped into the same. And we also call upon you.
The government, in collaboration with the Uganda High Commission in Kuala Lumpur, the Ministry of Internal Affairs, and the Office of the Prime Minister, initiated a series of diplomatic engagements with the government of Myanmar, leading to an engagement to release the Ugandans. The issue came to light in 2023 when reports surfaced about 23 Ugandans who were being held in Tachilek, Myanmar, after being lured with promises of high-paying jobs. The State Minister in charge of Children and Youth Affairs, Balaam Barugahara, on Saturday delivered President Museveni's message to the youth in Imbali, placing emphasis on educating them about the dangers related to using illicit drugs. This was during the Thanksgiving ceremony of Assistant RCC Imbali Hussein Gadimba, which took place at Nakaloke Playground in Northern City Division in Imbali City. Among those in attendance was the former Inspector General of Police, Kalika Ihura, politicians, religious and cultural leaders, as well as youth from Bugisu and surrounding districts. Barugahara warned the youth against getting involved in early sex acts that lead to teenage pregnancies. He also promised to crack down on culprits of defilement. The government has set up strategies to fight against drug trafficking and abuse. These include setting up of rehabilitation centers that also offer vocational skills to former drug abusers, organizing campaigns to sensitize the general population, as well as decentralizing mental health services.